So have you ever had one of those unexpected power outages cause damage to some of your equipment? Or maybe you lost data on your computer? Yeah, well, it's happened to me. And I'm going to show you a couple of things you can do to help prevent that. And they're easy and they're not real expensive. So stick around and let's get to it. Hey guys, Robert here again. So a while back I had a power outage that occurred and it damaged some networking equipment. And here recently, my power company, I guess, has been testing some emergency process, and we've had several nights at like midnight where they have shut the power off, but they didn't bother telling anybody they were doing that. Now, normally it's not a big deal, but I did have some data corruption actually on my PS5 because I leave it in the standby mode. So when the power just gets killed and it doesn't get a chance to actually shut down properly, it causes problems with the database. Well, got it all repaired. Everything's fine. But it got me thinking, you know, I have a big battery backup for my main computer here. My devices used to all be connected to that, but because of how I rearranged my office, those devices are a little far away and they can't plug into this battery backup. I decided I obviously need to have some smaller units for all my other components. And, you know, we talk a lot about, you know, smart home devices and gadgets around the house and, you know, electronics and components. But one thing I don't talk about enough, I don't think, is how to protect those devices because they're expensive. And you don't want some erroneous, you know, power outage frying your modem or your access point or your TV or your PlayStation or anything else that might be, you know, unprotected. So here's a simple and easy thing that you can do, and it's not too expensive. Get yourself a battery backup. This is a small one. It's only like 450, I think. Let's see. Yeah, 425 voltage amps. This isn't going to really power a computer system. They make bigger ones from that. Like the one I have over here is actually, I think, 1500 voltage amps. But I have, you know, my computer, my monitors, and all of that connected to it. So I want, it needs to be a little bit stronger. But small units like this are perfect for protecting your modem, your routers, access points that are plugged in, TVs, you know, PlayStations, things that don't pull a lot of power. And a small one like this will probably run devices like that for probably a good 45 minutes to an hour. So it gives you plenty of time. The one thing that a battery backup does is, well, twofold. One, it acts as a surge protector. So it helps regulate the power that comes in to either add to or subtract from if there's voltage spikes and, you know, where it dips. And then of course the battery provides power in a total power loss. So that way it gives you time to shut those components down. Now a battery backup is not designed to be used as a source of, I can just keep doing what I'm doing because it's not gonna last forever. But it's designed to give you the opportunity to shut the equipment down. So for example, like your computer, if the power goes out, the computer needs to be shut down. So it gives you time to go to the computer, log in, shut it down, and maybe even unplug it. So that way, when the power comes back up, you don't have any other kind of, you know, issues. But even with the battery backup, unplugging, it's not really that necessary. And of course, with your access points, your, you know, PlayStation, those other components, there's not really anything to shut down like on an access point or a mesh system, but it does give you the opportunity that you can kind of monitor, and you could, I guess, unplug it ahead of time before the power goes out. Unless you have some really long extended power outage, the battery is going to be sufficient to get you through the power outage. Now, I will say that there have been a couple of times where I've been gaming on my PlayStation and the power has gone out and I just kept playing because I had enough power. And of course, the internet stays up because my modem, my wireless mesh system, and all of those components are all attached to a battery backup. And so it lasts long enough for me to, you know, maybe finish a game or whatever I'm doing. And then, of course, I can shut the PlayStation down gracefully. I can shut my computer down and get, you know, wait until the power comes back on. And of course, once the power comes back on, the battery will automatically recharge itself and get back up to 100%. I just can't stress enough how important it is to protect your equipment. There's some equipment that's just not realistic in putting a battery everywhere in the house, but you want your core components, you know, your modem from your internet provider, your wireless mesh system or router if you have a third-party device connected to your modem. You want your TVs if you can. You want your PlayStations, your Xboxes, all of those components. They are expensive. And I can't tell you how many times over my IT career that I've seen devices get damaged because of a power outage. Devices you wouldn't think, like for example, a switch. Even though the switch itself might be unplugged in a battery backup, the actual Ethernet cable transmits electricity. And I've had ports on switches get damaged from a surge through an Ethernet wire. So you can't protect 100% of everything all the time, but you can definitely protect what's plugged into the wall, and you can definitely protect those components that are your core components. They're expensive. And let's take the expense out of it. Let's say that there's nothing damaged, but you suffer data loss because you had files open or a database got corrupted or something like that. That's no fun either. And in some cases, that's probably worse than damaging equipment because you can't get that back. You can always go buy another piece of equipment. But it's important to stay protected so that you don't have that type of damage. So, you know, I know this is not the most exciting video, but with all this power issues I've had lately and having that corruption on my PlayStation, it made me realize, you know, I need to talk about this because this is important. And like this unit here is like $50 or $60 on Amazon. Obviously you can get bigger ones. They're more expensive. I personally choose to use APC for the most part. I did purchase a couple of cyber powers. As a matter of fact, the big one over here is a cyber power because it was on sale and I actually wanted to test it out. And the bigger one works fine, but I do have a smaller cyber power downstairs and I don't particularly care for it. It's much bulkier than what this is. And as you can see right here from one that I already have hooked up, this is a reverse compact device and you can kind of stick it out of the way and it's not obtrusive. And the other one is just like really big and fat. it looks bad. It takes up a lot of room. But in my career as an IT professional, I've used tons of APC products and they just work. Again, they might be a little more expensive, not much for this type of device, but you get what you pay for. And these devices have been extremely reliable for me over my career. So I use them in my home as well. I will put links to these devices in the description so you can go check them out for yourself. I'll link to the CyberPower. You can go compare and see, you know, which one you want. Obviously, if you have a place to kind of put it out of sight, out of mind, the cyber power might be fine. Again, I just have had a tremendous success with the APC, which is actually made by Schneider Electric. And they've been a leader in this market segment for a long, long time. We protect all of our server equipment on the business side of things with APC units. And I can't think of a time that it's actually failed me. So it's definitely important. I will say also, if you get a little larger unit that has a USB connection, you can actually connect that to your computer, and then there's software you can install where you can schedule a safe shutdown for your desktop. So that way, if you're not at home or something to where you can't do a, you know, shut it down safely, the unit will do it for you. The software can be programmed to do that for you. So that gives you a little more peace of mind. So again, protect the equipment. It's vital. It's not a lot of money. I guarantee you, if you fried your $2,000 television because you didn't have into a battery backup, that's $60 for this battery backup would be nothing, and you would go buy it immediately. So don't wait. Go buy it. Links in the description. Go check them out. Find one that fits best for your needs, and you're good to go. If you have any questions on like sizes, because obviously, you know, they make, like this is a 450, they make 600, 650, 750, 1500. They make different levels of longevity as far as how long the battery will last. And of course, some of the bigger ones have a little more advanced features. But if you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them. So just put them in the comments and I'll get back to you. But don't wait until the power goes out and damages something, because then it's too late. You got to be proactive on this one. So protect that smart home equipment and get your battery backup. And you want to go watch this video right here that goes over that CyberPower unit that I put in sometime back.